Well, this is a very reasonable hand here. Got the tri-land, it has the debilitating injury, and has two very good morphs. Two of my better morphs, in fact. So, I like this spot. Ooh, and I drew a 2-drop? It's not the good one. I mean, Chief Dead is obviously fine, but Chief of the Scale is really what you want. 2-3 is just so much better. Well, Disowned Ancestor, not fitting into this curve as neatly as it has in others. Still a decent card. And Chief Edge is better with the Disowned Ancestor than Chief of the Scale is, that's for sure. Well, I can also... Yeah, I kind of like that. I'm just going to Debilitating Injury and play Disowned Ancestor. Get my 3 points of damage in. And put a 1-4 into play. Now my next opponent's next morph, I'll still probably attack with Chief of the Edge. I don't really have expectation of doing better. Mardu Skullhunter, unkicked. I like that. Actually, I think I'm just going to attack with this. The reason I'm doing that is my opponent might be trying to enable a second Skullhunter, and I would rather block with Disowned Ancestor, basically punish my opponent for trying to do that. And now I'm playing the Obzon Guide since I can flip it next turn. I think that's pretty clear as well. My opponent wants to attack. All right, no attacks. No tapping of mana. All right, now I'm sending them all in. See what my opponent does here. If you block Chief of the Edge, I'm okay with that. I'm just going to pass. Let my opponent be the first to act. I don't really want to flip my Obzon Guide and have it get throttled. So feed of resistance. Okay. Given that... No, let's still not flip the guide. Let's play a Woolly Loxodon face down and play another Disowned Ancestor. Now if I draw land, I can threaten to flip both or either morph. And if my opponent attacks and has another Skull Hunter, then sure, I lose Dazzling Ramparts, but probably not casting those anytime soon anyway. Being the first to untap with all your mana is pretty nice. I will give you that. Alright. Well, you know what? I'm just going to attack with the guide. I really don't want my Loxodon getting blocked here, even though this is potentially a little obvious that, you know, this is a morph that does not want to brawl here. I mean, it could just be Sidisi's pet. That would probably be pretty easy as well. Alright, let's just hit for 2 because I want a debilitating injury the morph before it flips into something more impressive. Well, Canyon Lunaker is not actually more impressive. And might as well outlast. Passing of the turn. Now my opponent could cast Doom Blast. Okay. Let's just hit with the guide again. This time I am flipping it. Reason being that I want to be able to flip my Loxodon next turn, and I drew a 6 land. Since I know that's going to happen. And it was a tap land, otherwise I could have attacked with both. Ah, finally, the Canyon Lurker splash is live. Alright, time to send in the clowns. Opponent's got to do something or die here. And I have the ability to flip into a 6-7, and my opponent didn't play anything last turn, and has to have something pretty impressive here. Alright, I'm just going to go for the flip. I mean, I could have not flipped, but there's so few cards my opponent can have if I flip there. I could have not flipped under the assumption that my opponent's going to use something to use a trick on the Obzon Guide, but I think I'm just good just to flip them right up.